In the previous video, we derived these equations of motion for a rigid body for wrenches, twists, and accelerations defined in a body frame B. In this video, we express these equations in a form analogous to the equations of motion for a body that only rotates. To do this, we define the 6x6 spatial inertia matrix GB. The top left 3x3 submatrix is the inertia matrix IB, and the bottom right 3x3 submatrix is a diagonal matrix, the mass of the body multiplied by the 3x3 identity matrix. With this, the kinetic energy of a rotating and translating rigid body can be written as the sum of the rotational kinetic energy and the linear kinetic energy, or simply 1/2 times the body twist transpose times GB times the body twist. Also, just like the mass matrix of a robot in the rotational inertia matrix IB, the spatial inertia matrix GB is symmetric and positive definite. Before proceeding further, we need to define an operation on six-dimensional twists that is analogous to the cross-product operation on three-dimensional vectors. Remember that we use the bracket notation to write the cross-product of omega 1 and omega 2 in R3. The result is a 3-vector. The 3x3 little SO3 matrix form of this cross-product is bracket omega 1 times bracket omega 2 minus bracket omega 2 times bracket omega 1. For six-dimensional twists, our analogy to the cross product is bracket V1 times bracket V2 minus bracket V2 times bracket V1, a 4x4 matrix in little SE3. In vector form, this is little add V1 times V2, where the little adjoint of a twist V is defined by the 6x6 matrix shown here. Little add V1 times V2 is the Lie bracket of V1 and V2. The Lie bracket of V1 and V2 is an acceleration, measuring how motion along the twist V2 would change if the body follows the twist V1. The matrix form of the Lie bracket is analogous to the matrix form of the cross product. Returning now to our equations of motion, after a little manipulation, we find that these equations can be expressed as this 6-vector equation. The wrench FB equals GB times VB dot minus little add VB transpose times GB times VB. Notice that the second term is a velocity product term. This equation is analogous to the equation for a rotating rigid body, replacing the rotational inertia matrix IB with the spatial inertia matrix GB, the angular velocity omega B with the twist VB, and the cross product with omega B with the Lie bracket with VB. Now that we have the equation of motion in the B frame, we could ask what the equation of motion is in a different frame, A. Equating the kinetic energy expressed in each frame, we find an expression for the 6x6 spatial inertia matrix expressed in the A frame, GA, in terms of the GB matrix in the transform TBA expressing the A frame and the B frame. With this inertia matrix, we find that the equation of motion in terms of the wrench FA, the spatial inertia matrix GA, and the twist VA has the same form as it does in the B frame. We usually prefer to write the equations in terms of a center of mass frame, B, however. To wrap up, we have derived the inverse dynamics for a rigid body. Given the twist and acceleration, we can calculate the wrench needed to generate this motion. We can also write the forward dynamics, which takes the current twist and the applied wrench and calculates the acceleration. In the next video, we will use these results to derive the recursive Newton-Euler algorithm for the inverse dynamics of a robot.